I'm going to discuss the CLAT 2021 general knowledge section that was given by thousands of students across the country on 23rd of July, 2021. And in this particular video of analysis of GK section, I'm going to critically analyze the passages that have been asked in the CLAT 2021 paper with the intention to bring you utmost clarity about the nature of the questions, the source of the questions, and the depth of the questions, so that you become completely aware as to what exactly is the type and the depth of the questions that you can expect in the next year's CLAT examination. Okay. So with this intention, I would like to give my, best shot, and I would like to explain it to you to the core. I hope this session will help you in terms of becoming very clear about it. The GK, which is a very, problematic subject to most of the students, and I do get a lot of queries and concerns. So I believe the best way to address this issue is to analyze the actual CLAT paper, okay? So let us look at the questions that came in the CLAT 2021 paper. The first and foremost passage that you can see here is about the Ramsar site, Tsokar. You can clearly see there's a this thing is called as Tsokar. This is the site, Tsokar, that was included in the list of Ramsar sites in India. It lies in Ladakh region. So if you read this whole passage, you will understand that they are talking about the Ramsar sites and Ramsar convention related, issue. So first, let us try to understand how important is this topic. Kitna important data. Now, generally speaking, it does not look as if it's very important. But if you look at it from a very broad perspective, Ramsar Convention is mainly for protecting the biodiversity and, the wetlands and their conservation, which has a linkage with the ecological balance, okay, which is again linked with the issues that the whole world is facing in terms of climate change. So if you can link it to the climate change context, it seems as if it's an important topic, right? So this was the passage that was given to you. Now, another question, I would like to resolve all of your questions in the GK thing, which you mostly come across. Many students, while giving mocks and all, they keep on asking, sir, is this necessary? Is this necessary to read the passage when you are solving the question of GK? So my advice to all of you would be, first and foremost, when you see the passage, first you read the few lines, India has added Tsokar, a wetland complex in Ladakh as 42nd Ramsar site. And all. So reading the passage is only required when you are not able to solve the questions. There are five questions followed by that. So the first advice to most of the aspirants is, you please try not to read the passage. You just directly go to the question and see if you can solve the question by directly, looking at it, solve it then and there. But if in the question, there is some problem, you're not able to really grasp the question, or you are not able to get a clue in that question, and if you feel internally that I should look at the passage to get the clarity, in that case only you need to look at the passage. Okay, so this is a very, very important input. I mean, you must note it down that it is not at all necessary to read the passage to crack the questions. So the first approach should be go to the question directly. Why am I saying this? I am saying this because in the actual CLAT paper, time management is of utmost importance. And there have been a lot of theories and, you know, philosophies in which people proclaim that you must invest 10 minutes in GK, somebody says 15 minutes in GK, somebody says 8 minutes in GK. My suggestion is every person is unique. Everybody has his or her own speed and understanding. So it's very difficult to fix what is the standard time to solve the questions. It depends on the nature of the question. It depends on the depth of the question. It depends upon your level of preparation. Okay. So you cannot fix the time as such, but you have to have a broad outline up to which you need to finish. So suppose we take it to be 10 minutes time period. So I hope you completely understand that when you're not reading the passage, you're saving that much of seconds or say minute for that matter. Therefore, this advice is very important. I hope it is very clear to you. Go to the questions directly, point number one. So I'm giving the strategy also along with this. Now, when you pick up this passage, so first we need to really understand this passage has been picked up just to highlight that the examiner considers the ecological balance, biodiversity, and climate change as an important area. And that is why they are picking it up. I mean, is it a worthy topic to be picked up? We are nobody to take a call on this. It's the examiner's discretion. So we have to go by that. So are we drawing any learning from this passage? Kya is passage mein kuch learnings hain? Yes, learnings hain. Learnings ye hain ki when you are preparing for the CLAT 2022 paper, you must pay attention to any development or any topic or any issue which has a direct or indirect linkage with climate change, ecology, or environment. I know when I'm making this statement, it's a very big statement, very bold statement, because there are so many news items which come across day-to-day in your day-to-day life. But with experience, we can figure out, you know, it's an important event. Can you see there's a site getting added to the Ramsar sites list of India? It's a big development. You can filter out that this is relevant or not relevant. Okay, so it is relevant, surely. So one learning is that this passage is talking about the climate change and ecological balance. So I need to be aware of such topics if they are there in the forthcoming, you know, my preparation of the CLAT examination. Now let us look at the question. The main thing is to solve the questions, right? The first data, which is a good one, it says, which of the following sites in India is not included in the Ramsar wetland list? Options are ASEAN Conservation Reserve, Uttarakhand. I am sorry, there is an error here. It's not ASEAN, it is ASAN actually, A-S-A-N. So there's an error here. Dal Lake, Jammu and Kashmir, Kabartal Wetland, Bihar, Lunar Lake, Maharashtra. Now, this is a good question. Ye sawal achha hai. Why? This is a good question because if you have been reading the newspapers and news items since last, you know, since the time the 2020 paper happened, if you see, just to share with you, I have taught students of our program and we have discussed manthans at length. And if you have read it religiously, so you will find that we did topics on Kabartal, Wetland, Bihar. We did about this ASAN Conservation Reserve. In fact, this question is basically a contemporary question. It's picking up all the latest Ramsar site, you know, inclusions in a particular list. And they're asking which one is not a part of that. So those of you who have gone through the Ramsar sites off late regularly in the current affairs, they only can crack this question. It's a good question. I would rate it as a good one. Achha sawal banaya hai. So Dal Lake definitely is the answer. Therefore, answer is option B. Dhyan rahe, when we are solving such questions, we say it's not included. Don't go by the fact that when we read, we say which is the following is included. So in a hurried manner, no need to, you know, overlook not here. If you overlook not, you are gone. So this is what the answer is. The answer is option B, Dal Lake. So it's a, let me analyze this question. Can we call it as a static GK question? Definitely not. Why? Because rest of jitne bhi points isme diye hue hain, ASAN and Kabartal and Lunar, they are all contemporary developments. In the last 10 months or so, they have been included in the Ramsar site list of India. So it's a purely current affairs question. Okay. So we can see one question coming up. That is the current affairs question. For sure. Done. Now we look at question number two. It says the World Wetlands Day is celebrated on. The answer to this question is second day of February. That is the right answer. But date-wise, it will be 2nd February. So option C. So in this case, the answer is option B. In this case, the answer is option C. Now let us analyze this question again. It talks about important days. Many times when students, you know, they attend my lectures, I have come across, you know, statements from the students saying that, sir, when we are doing the CLAT passages, is there any worth of doing the important days? You can clearly see the reflection here. They're talking about an important day here. And again, there are people who say it's a static GK question. I agree it's a static GK question, but look at the time frame. It's talking about February 2. You were supposed to prepare the data from September 1, 2020 to July 22, 2021. So if you see it, it lies between September and July. So it's the current affairs time period. Got it? So February 2 lies in the current affairs time range. So one thing is for sure, you need to do the days. It's coming from there. And this February 2 is the date. That is the answer. So days are important, but in the current context again. Now the third one, the theme of the world for the World Wetlands Day is, you know, the answer to this question would be, it's option B is the right answer. Okay. Wetlands and water. So the right answer is option B, wetlands and water. Now in this question also, you must be wondering कि ये जो क्वेश्चन है इसमें थीम पूछा गया है नॉट एन इजी नट टू क्रैक आसान नहीं है बिकॉज जनरली वी डिस्कार्ड सच काइंड ऑफ डेज वी से नो वेटलैंड डे हाउ इंपॉर्टेंट इज दैट बट व्हेन यू आर डूइंग वेटलैंड का टॉपिक सो डे एंड थीम आल्सो बिकम्स इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर श्योर इट वेटलैंड्स एंड वॉटर दैट इज द करेक्ट आंसर ऑप्शन बी सो इफ यू हैव डन दिस टॉपिक थॉरली इट वॉन्ट बी अ वेरी डिफिकल्ट क्वेश्चन टू क्रैक वेटलैंड एंड वॉटर श्योरली बी इज द आंसर इज दिस अ स्टैटिक जीके क्वेश्चन डेफिनेटली नॉट It's a current GK question. This question is coming in the month of February, about the theme of World Wetland Day 2021. They're not talking about the theme of World Wetland Day when it began way back many years ago. The world's largest mangrove forest is located in, I think this is a static GK question, the Sundarban mangroves. It's very, very famous. I mean, those of you who have done very basic, you know, geography, you will not find it difficult to crack. Sundarban Delta is the world's largest delta also, which is created by two rivers, Gangaji and Brahmaputra. So Sundarban mangroves are the largest mangrove forest. See, if you ask me, I will not rate it as a very difficult question. It's a doable question. You know, if you are slightly well-read, you can crack it. This is a static GK question, but again, it's a standard question. It's not a very old types question ki mujhe batao ki, 19th parallel is a line which runs between these two countries. Definitely not. Straight question, right? So the answer is option A. We move on to the next one. And the next data is, it says on the day of the World Wetland, on the occasion of the World Wetland Day, and it's part of, commitment to conservation, restoration, management of India's wetland established by the name of, there's a center that has been announced. And the center is, Center for Wetland Conservation and Management. The answer to this question would be, let me tell you, its answer is option D. Now, here I want to add some value. Now, this question is a very good question. Let me tell you why it's a good question. In the context of this particular thing, it's a good question. Why? Because they have linked with the Wetland Day, Wetland Day ka जो सेलिब्रेशन हुआ था उसको इन लोगों ने इंडिया में जो वेटलैंड डे एस्टैब्लिश डे पर जो इंस्टीट्यूशन एस्टैब्लिश हो रहा है उसके साथ लिंक कर दिया है इफ आई एम नॉट रॉन्ग इट इज लोकेटेड इन चेन्नई राइट सो द आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन वुड बी ऑप्शन डी नाउ लेट अस एनालाइज दीज क्वेश्चंस वंस मोर एक बार इनको फिर से एनालाइज करते हैं जस्ट टू अंडरस्टैंड कि ये पैसेज कितना इंपॉर्टेंट है और इसमें जो क्वेश्चंस पूछे गए हैं वो कितने इंपॉर्टेंट है सी व्हेन आई टॉक अबाउट दिस पैसेज I'll call it as a current affairs topic for sure. Though, according to me, it sounds as important. But if you compare this passage as compared to you know, the topics like India, Afghanistan peace process, or India, government of India versus Twitter, if you talk about passages like in Israel-Palestine conflict, and, you know, many more assembly polls in four states, and COVID vaccination and COVID's third wave, you name it, they are there. There are so many passages, so many issues that could have come to your paper. But I cannot say that this is not a very relevant, you know, that they have picked up. It is relevant because it is dealing with biodiversity, ecological balance, and, you know, climate change. So it has a direct or indirect connection with the environment. Makes sense to do. But the ones who have done the weekly manthan thoroughly, you must have gone through this news item. It's there in our manthan for sure. That's what I'm trying to highlight. By the way, let me also share with you the source of this particular passage so that you become clear. Okay. Now, here is the source. Let me just share it with you. I mean, give me a sec, please. Yeah. I hope it is very much visible to all of you. So if you see, this is the source. And can you see the date here? The important date mentioned here is 24 December 2020. So this particular, you know, passage is coming from Ministry of Environment Press Information Bureau. That is the source of this passage. If you read, every word has been taken from there. And please also understand, aapko ye bhi samajhna padega, ki from this particular starting passage only, sirf itne se passage se, they have created a, you know, block of a question. So the important point that I want to highlight is, this is coming from Press Information Bureau, Government of India website, and the date is 24 December 2020. So if there is anybody who is saying that this time, you know, static GK was asked in so much of amount, I really don't buy that argument. Look at the date of publication, 24 December 2020. So that is something which is very, very important. Okay. That is why I'm sharing this source with you. Now we move on to another important, you know, passage, and that is passage number two. And this passage is all about, let's just have a look at it. The search for efficient trade routes and better connectivity has been one of the powerful driving force of the different prospects of many nations, regions, civilizations. And today, the world goes through a fundamental rebalancing, correcting the direction. It is only natural that connectivity should be central to its growth in trade, commerce, industrial development, maritime shift in fulcrum of global economic growth towards Asia. The government recognized the importance of regional connectivity, made a landmark decision to undertake an overseas port investment in Charwahar. Now this is something interesting. Let's first solve the questions and then I will share the sources with you. The first question that is being asked is, it says, the Chabahar Day was commemorated by the Ministry of Ports, Shipping and Waterways in which of the following summit? The answer to this question is Maritime India Summit. That is the answer to this question. So please, you can note it down. The answer is Maritime India Summit. Now, if you see this particular news item, so the first thing that comes to the mind is they're talking about an issue called Chabahar Port. That is fine, wonderful. But many students start thinking that Chabahar Port is an old issue. So they are talking about the data which is beyond 2020. See, the sources that I figured out, let me tell you, this was a speech of, it was the speech of probably S. Jaishankar, the Ministry of External Affairs, ki jo hamare minister hain, unki speech thi. Aur iska jo timeline hai, let me tell you, the timeline is March 2021. So if you come across any news item which is related with this, you can search it, you will get it for sure. I'm quite sure you will get it. If you read the passage, it says, it talks about the search for efficient trade routes, better connectivity has been one of the powerful driving forces of history. And in that context only, the shift in the fulcrum of global economic growth towards Asia. So it was published in March 2020. Just a minute. Let me just share it with you so that it's visible. This is the source. Can you see shift in the fulcrum of economic growth towards Asia? This is the line. And if you see this line, here it goes. It says the shift in the fulcrum of, can you see that? Fulcrum of global economic growth towards Asia. Can you see that? Similar. So it is, if you see the publication time, if you see when was it published? So I'm just going through that just to prove it to you. It's coming in March 2021. And this is nothing, but it is basically celebration of Chabahar Day. That is what this question is all about. So please understand, आपको ये समझना पड़ेगा यहाँ पर कि जो बार बार questions खड़े होते हैं कि static GK पे question है, मैं उसको बहुत highlight करना चाह रहा हूँ बार बार, ये उतना important नहीं है. चाबहार डे का जो discussion हुआ था वो एक maritime summit हुआ था इंडिया में, उस पर discussion हुआ. It's coming from there. So answer is option D. We move on to the next one, 37th question. It says, which of the following is correct about the Chabahar port? Now, this is something which is a very difficult question to crack. Let me tell you, because it talks about correct about Chabahar port. So you need to know the facts about it. It is located in the southeast of Iran in Oman Sea. Though it sounds logical, you should know the location because it is a port. It has a marine border of more than 300 kilometers. Now, this is a too specific. This is too specific a fact to be retained. To my mind, I will not encourage you to retain this much of data. Definitely not. If you can do, then do, or else you leave it. So it says, which of the following is correct? I would say option C. Definitely, that is correct. So the answer to this particular one would be option C. Both A and B are correct. But I will rate this question as a difficult question. Your question difficult, definitely. You'll have to retain exactly things and then only you can find it. ठीक है? We move on to the next one. और आगे बढ़ जाते हैं. Let's see. Which of the following statements relate to the Chabahar port and its impact? If you read the statements, it is a transit hub to support landlocked countries of Central Asia. Sure. It will play an important role in international north-south transit corridor. If you look at north-south transit corridor, INSTC, definitely it is, you know, going to play because it has a transition thing. It helps in movement. So link has koi do raha nahi. It will optimize the logistics cost by bringing in efficiency and creating a reliable and safe transport corridor. Of course. So is pure ke pure issue mein tino ki tino cheeze mujhe important nazar aa rahi hai, and the answer should be all of them are correct. Okay, so answer is D. But this question is not a factual question, guys. This question is understanding based question. If you have done the Chabahar port issue thoroughly, then only you can crack this question. So aise mein generally aisa dekha gaya hai ki examiner jo questions poochte hain, which of the following is true ya not true mein, generally sare statement true hote hain, generally. But it's not the way jisko tumhe follow karna hai. Generally true hote hain. तो क्या मैं तुक्का मार दूं क्या? No. If you are not sure, you can leave it. But this demands comprehensive understanding. So we are getting a question here, which is based on the conceptual understanding of the particular topic. So when I'm talking about conceptual question, and if I go back, and if I look at all the questions that I have done, the first five questions, first question is purely factual. Second question is factual. Third question is factual. Fourth question is factual. And fifth question is also factual. Five of them are factual questions. The first one, kab hu kahan pe hua, it's a factual one. Chabahar port ke bare mein sahi nahi hai. It's a, I would say, though it is factual, but demands comprehensive understanding. If you know what is the location, if you know how many kilometers, then only you can crack this one. Now look at question 38. It demands a lot of understanding. It's a conceptual question. So we move on to another one. Ek aur question dekhte hain. Is the result of trilateral agreement between which three countries? I think you know this. Agar jisne Chabahar port ko dhang se padha hai, India, Iran aur Afghanistan, inhi ka ye trilateral coordination tha. India beech mein isme back out kar gaya tha. Agar tumhe pata ho, Chabahar ek port hai. और इसमें इंडिया को भी फायदा हो रहा था, इसीलिए इंडिया इसको सपोर्ट कर रहा था. लेकिन बाद में कुछ क्लॉज फुलफिलमेंट ना करने की वजह से इंडिया ने इसमें से विड्रॉ भी किया था. दैट वाज द न्यूज़. बट ओरिजिनली दिस वाज साइंड बाय दीस थ्री कंट्रीज. So it's an easy question. It's a fairly easy question. Provided you have studied, it's crackable. Bilkul crackable. So option A should be the right answer to this. Let's move on to the 40th question. It says, which of the following special purpose vehicle incorporated for the development and management of Shaheed Behesti Port of Chabahar? Guys, this is too much to ask for. किसी ने अगर चाबहार पोर्ट को बहुत डिटेल में प्रिपेयर किया होगा तो ही इस क्वेश्चन को क्रैक कर सकता है. इट्स नॉट दैट इजी नट टू क्रैक. तो द आंसर फॉर योर रेफरेंस आई कैन टेल यू इज ऑप्शन सी, इंडिया पोर्ट्स ग्लोबल लिमिटेड. एक अलग से एंटिटी बनाई गई थी जो शाहिद बहेस्ती पोर्ट ऑफ चाबहार को मेंटेन करने के लिए बनाई गई थी. राइट नाउ इन दिस पैसेज लेट्स रीलुक एट दिस पैसेज वंस मोर. एक बार दोबारा देखते हैं इस पैसेज को. This passage is basically a generic commentary, general commentary. कब का published है ये passage? March 2021 का published है. So it's a current affairs topic. What is this all about? It's basically the speech of S. Jayashankar, जो press information bureau में छपी थी. So can I clearly see कि जो sources हैं, ये बहुत interesting observation share कर रहा हूँ कि ये पहला passage coming for press information bureau. All the questions are factual in nature. Second question is again coming from Press Information Bureau. It's coming from the statement of the minister, sir. And if you look at the questions, there is one factual question. There is question number 39, that is a factual one. And question number 40, factual. So three factual questions and two conceptual questions. So I am able to become aware that in the CLAT, the nature of questions is majorly factual. And the other type of questions you can expect is conceptual questions also. Now, this brings me to a point. A very important point yahan pe highlight hota hai. The point ye hai ki when I say I have to be conceptually clear, so what is the depth of my understanding that I must possess to become and claim that I am conceptually clear? If you look at these questions, for example, in the 37th question, the first data is, it says located in the southeast of Iran in Oman Sea. So, I mean, asking about the location of the port, is it a big deal? I really don't think so. This is something which is expected. Pata hona chahiye. Now, the second point is a marine border of around 300 kilometer. If you're good in geography and if you've really read it, you should do it. But the first line that has been asked is something which is doable. You must know where is the location. And if you look at question number 30, it will give you a lot of clarity. Transit hub to support landlocked countries of Central Asia, important on international north-south transit corridor. Then again, it will optimize the logistic cost of bringing efficiency and creating a reliable ship. See, this question demands that have you really understood the Chabahar port and its implications? So the depth that is required is of moderate level of understanding. They are not asking ki India, Iran or Afghanistan ki relationship badhne se America kya reaction karega ya China isko kaise dekh raha hai ya Pakistan isme kaise retaliate karega. So jab tum log ye analysis karte ho to tum log ko major problem ye hoti ki sir kis depth tak analysis karna hai, kis depth tak conceptual clarity honi chahiye. Mere hisab se basic aur moderate level ki clarity is good enough. Kyunki dekho is port se tum clearly samajh sakte ho transition ke liye facilitate karega, efficiency ko badhava dega. और डेफिनेटली ये यू नो पर्टिकुलर ट्रेड रूट्स को बढ़ावा देगा. तो ये कॉमन सेंस अप्लाई करके भी क्रैक कर सकते हो प्रोवाइडेड यू नो समथिंग अबाउट द पोर्ट. सो मेरा एक बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट लर्निंग यहां निकल के बाहर आ रहा है कि मुझे जब कॉन्सेप्चुअल क्लैरिटी करनी है तो मुझे कॉन्सेप्चुअल क्लैरिटी जो है वो मीडियोकर लेवल पे कॉन्सेप्चुअल क्लैरिटी चाहिए. मुझे बहुत डिटेल में कॉन्सेप्चुअल क्लैरिटी नहीं चाहिए. देर आर सो मेनी स्टूडेंट्स हु व्हेन दे स्टार्ट प्रिपेयरिंग टॉपिक्स एंड ऑल they research it from 10 sources and then they go very deep in terms of understanding this. I really do not think that is required. It is required, but at a moderate level of understanding. If you are a good reader, if you are a sensible reader, you will easily make out as to what kind of data that the examiner is asking. So you don't really have to too much be worried about it. Ki mujhe depth ka matlab hai, bahut detail mein karna hai. Definitely not. It's too clear. We move on to the next one. It was a factual one, fourth one. And the fifth one is also a factual one. So out of these five questions, I'm finding around at least two questions difficult, three doable. In the first passage, I'm finding out of five, four doable and one non-doable. Please understand that when I'm saying doable and, you know, workable and all, so I'm assuming that you are working हार्ड, आई एम अज्यूमिंग दैट यू आर वर्किंग अबव एवरेज लेवल ऑफ हार्ड वर्क, अगर तुम इतनी मेहनत कर रहे हो जिस जो कि बहुत से बच्चे करते हैं, तो मैं नहीं समझता कि दिस क्वेश्चंस आर नॉट डूएबल. लेट्स मूव ऑन टू अनदर पैसेज. लेट मी लुक एट दिस पैसेज. इट टॉक्स अबाउट नरेंद्र मोदी ड्यूरिंग विजिट टू बांग्लादेश कांग्रेचुलेटेड द नेबरिंग कंट्री फॉर द 50th ईयर ऑफ इंडिपेंडेंस. सो बेसिकली बांग्लादेश के 50 साल पूरे हुए, ठीक है, उसी के कंटेक्स्ट में इंडिया और बांग्लादेश के जो रिलेशंस हैं उसमें रिवाइवल हुआ. सो उसी कंटेक्स्ट में नरेंद्र मोदी विजिटेड बांग्लादेश एंड लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स हैपेंड. नाउ लेट मी जस्ट हैव अ लुक एट दिस सोर्स ऑफ दिस पैसेज. इसका सोर्स देख लेते हैं. एंड द सोर्स इज इट्स एन आर्टिकल which is published in Free Press Journal. ये article यहाँ से published है. Let me show it to you. Here it comes. This is the particular article. You can see that. It says, Prime Minister Narendra Modi was in two-day visit to Bangladesh, congruent neighboring country, on Friday, 50th year of independence. And then he was talking about, I was about 22 years old. Let's see, look at the actual passage. एक बार actual passage को भी देखते हैं. And here is the actual passage. So can you see, it's the exact passage that they have picked up. Now, where is this passage coming from? Let me pay some attention to it. There's a website called Free Press Journal. Us press journal par ye article chhapa tha. Aur iski date of publication dekh lete hain. You can you see that? Is this visible to you? I believe so. So can you see the date here? It says March 26, 2021. So can you see this article is coming from March 26? So it's a current affairs topic for sure. ये बहुत ही हॉट टॉपिक है, डूएबल था, यू कैन मेक आउट, एंड दैट इज व्हाट दे हैव आस्क्ड. द गांधी पीस प्राइज इज अवार्डेड फॉर, क्लियरली मेंशनड है 2020 का बंग बंधु शेख मुजीबुर रहमान को. सो ऐसे क्वेश्चन को व्हेन यू से इट्स अ स्टैटिक जीके क्वेश्चन, श्योरली इट्स अ स्टैटिक जीके क्वेश्चन, इट्स अ डूएबल क्वेश्चन. गांधी जी वॉज नोन फॉर सोशल जस्टिस, यू नो, नॉन वायलेंस, and economic and political, you know, changes. If you see the options, non-cooperation against social injustice, it was confined to the Britishers' period of time. So logically, you can eliminate. Humanitarian leadership, it's a very generic term. Social and economic development in villages, sure, it was there. But if I look at option D, social, economic, and political transformation through non-violence, his mainstay was non-violence. So this question, even if you do not know Gandhi Peace Prize is given for what purpose, by looking at the options, you can crack this question. I know it's surely a doable data. Bilkul kar sakte hain, aur bahut hi easy question hai, and the right answer is option D. Let's move on and see some more questions. So yahan par mera ek input aa raha hai bahut acha. Bahut sare students is baat ko leke bahut hi ghabraye hue rehte hain. कि अगर हमने इसको नहीं पढ़ा या ये नॉलेज हमारे पास नहीं है तो हम क्वेश्चन क्रैक नहीं कर सकते. अगर आपने गांधी पीस प्राइज किस लिए दिया जाता है, अगर आपने ये भी नहीं पढ़ा है तो भी आप ऑप्शन देख करके क्वेश्चन को क्रैक कर सकते हैं. इतना डिफिकल्ट नहीं है ये पेपर जितना आप लोग सोच रहे हैं. एंड लुक एट क्वेश्चन नंबर 42. इट टॉक्स अबाउट गांधी पीस प्राइज वॉज अवॉर्डेड फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम इन द ईयर 1995 टू. लेट मी टेल यू, अब इसको तुम बाई चांस बोलो या फैक्चुअल डेटा बोलो. This particular question I have asked in my master stroke session. Those of you who have watched it, they must second for this. It is Julius Nyerere, former president of Tanzania. So are we drawing any learning from this? Yes, there's a learning. And the learning is, when you're doing an important award, so the history of that award is also something that you need to pay attention to. You know, who was the first recipient? And that too for very specific awards, not every award. There's an award called, say, Vachaspati Puraskar, से बिहारी पुरस्कार, से के सरस्वती सम्मान. आई विल नॉट गो फॉर द फर्स्ट रेसिपिएंट्स इन दिस. आई वुड श्योरली गो फॉर भारत रत्न, गांधी पीस प्राइज, वर्ल्ड फूड प्राइज, नोबेल प्राइज, ऑस्कर, बुकर. सो इट मेक्स ऑल ऑफ सेंस टू डू द हिस्टोरिकल पर्सपेक्टिव. एंड डेफिनेटली द आंसर इज ऑप्शन ए. इट्स अ प्योरली फैक्चुअल क्वेश्चन. क्वेश्चन नंबर 43. विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इंडियन ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस वाज अवार्डेड गांधी पीस प्राइज इन द ईयर in the beginning, in the year 2014. So this is a difficult question. If you have read it, so you are not supposed to retain all the years and the organizations. So yahan pe agar gut feeling tumhare paas hai, to agar tum usse explore kar sakte ho, to the answer is ISRO. But still, I would rate it as a difficult question. Ye aasan nahi hai, because you are not supposed to retain 2014 ka data. It's a difficult nut to crack. शेख मुजीबुर रहमान इज द फर्स्ट व्हाट प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ बांग्लादेश. इज अ फेयरली इजी क्वेश्चन, ये न्यूज में चल रहा था. So the answer to these questions would be, let me mark it for you. You know, the answer for this one is ISRO. The answer for this one is president. And he was assassinated on. The answer is 15 August ko inki death hui thi. Aur 71 mein Bangladesh bana tha. So elimination bhi apply kar do. 75 is the answer. But yahan pe question uthta hai. Sir, are we supposed to retain the death of the president of Bangladesh or father of the nation of Bangladesh? I think it's a very, very tricky question, but you are expected to do that because the date is 15th of August, India ka Independence Day. And jis bande ki hum baat kar rahe hain, inki jo death hui hai, ye Bangladesh ke father figure hain. Is this like saying Mahatma Gandhi ka death day kab hota hai? You know, 30th of January 1948, Martyrs Day ke roope manate. उसी तरीके से शेख मुजीबुर रहमान साहब का डेथ डे भी इंपॉर्टेंट नजर आता है. इट्स अ डिफिकल्ट क्वेश्चन टू क्रैक. लेट मी टेल यू, आई वुड रेट दिस दीस क्वेश्चंस एज सच. क्वेश्चन नंबर 41, इट्स अ फैक्चुअल क्वेश्चन, श्योरली नो कॉन्सेप्ट्स इन्वॉल्व. क्वेश्चन नंबर 42 प्योरली फैक्चुअल. क्वेश्चन नंबर 43 अगेन इट्स अ फैक्चुअल क्वेश्चन. 44 इज अगेन अ फैक्चुअल क्वेश्चन. 45 इज अगेन अ फैक्ट. सो ऑल ऑफ देम आर फैक्चुअल क्वेश्चंस, प्रोवाइडेड यू हैव डन इट थॉरली, यू कैन क्रैक इट. But I really liked, you know, the way the questions have been framed. अच्छा लगा मुझे, especially ये first question जो first winner of Gandhi Peace Prize पूछा गया, बहुत बढ़िया. But अगर level of difficulty देखें, पहला question doable है, second question भी doable है, third question that is कौन सी organization, I think it's a difficult one to crack. Fourth question is Sheikh Mujibur Rahman, it's a fairly easy nut. And then 45th is also under the doable category. मेरे को लगता है ये हो जाना चाहिए, बहुत specific है. Out of 5, 4 questions are doable. This is what I have to say. I hope things are becoming clearer to you. And a very interesting observation is ki jitne bhi passages humne kiye hain, pehla passage December ka data hai, baki jo passages hain wo March ka data hai. To jitne bhi article chhap rahe hain, sare current affairs ke article hain. Tum log usko leke pareshan mat ho. Is a static GK ke andar hum kaise kar, kahan se karenge. गिने चुने स्ट्रैटेजी के क्वेश्चन. और सबसे इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट, एनी स्ट्रैटेजी के क्वेश्चन दैट यू आर एनकाउंटरिंग हियर, इट्स इन द कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ द करंट इवेंट. सो आई रियली डू नॉट थिंक दैट इट्स अ मैटर ऑफ वरी एट ऑल. स्ट्रैटेजी को लेके बच्चे इतने परेशान रहते हैं, कोई जरूरत नहीं है. कॉन्टेक्स्चुअल इशू को तुम ढंग से पढ़ रहे हो, उसी कॉन्टेक्स्ट में उसकी हिस्ट्री दी होती है, वो इसके स्ट्रैटेजी के का पार्ट हो जाता है. दिस इज द वे वी लुक एट इट. एंड वी विल मूव ऑन टू अनदर पर्टिकुलर टॉपिक हियर. And that is, the fourth one, and that's about UNESCO. So let's move on to passage number 4, which talks about UNESCO's New Delhi along with National Mission for Clean Ganga Partners Day. So this particular passage is talking about World Water Day. World Water Day is celebrated on March 2022. So this news item is also for the month of March. Let me see the source. Iski source dekhte hain. 22nd March 2021. So it's a current affairs topic. And this is again coming from Press Information Bureau. So please understand the source of this passage is again Press Information Bureau. So many a times there is a myth among the students. Bahut se students ke beech mein myth rehta hai. Many students think ki humko BBC ki websites padhni chahiye, humko हिंदू न्यूज पेपर पढ़ना चाहिए, हमको इंडियन एक्सप्रेस पढ़ना चाहिए, हमको इंटरनेशनल जर्नल्स पढ़ने चाहिए, तो वहां से डेटा आता है. इट इज ऑल इलॉजिकल. प्लीज अंडरस्टैंड, आई हैव सॉल्व 4 पैसेजेस आउट ऑफ विच 3 आर कमिंग फ्रॉम, प्लीज अंडरस्टैंड, 3 पैसेजेस आर कमिंग फ्रॉम प्रेस इंफॉर्मेशन ब्यूरो. 1 पैसेज इज कमिंग फ्रॉम वेबसाइट, फ्री प्रेस जर्नल का वेबसाइट है, वहां से आया है. So, ये बेसिकली वर्ल्ड वाटर डे के ऊपर फोकस कर रहा है. लेट्स लुक एट द क्वेश्चंस. फेयरली इजी नट टू क्रैक. बहुत आसान सवाल है. इट्स नथिंग. इट टॉक्स अबाउट मार्च 22. व्हाट इज द थीम? यस, इट्स अगेन वेरी वेरी इजी. एंड द थीम इज वैल्यूइंग वाटर. इफ यू सी ये जो क्वेश्चंस हैं, लेट मी, आई फील वेरी हैप्पी टू शेयर विद यू दैट इन माय मंथन, इन माय मास्टर स्ट्रोक सेशन, आई हैव क्रिएटेड अ सिंगल क्वेश्चन व्हिच हैड बोथ द क्वेश्चंस. यू नो, what is the day on which World Water Day is celebrated? What is the theme for 2021? The answer is March 2022 and valuing water. So in one question, we were solving 2 mass questions. So I'm feeling very happy because I created it and came in your paper. That's why I'm happy. कि जब भी कभी हम ये चीजें prepare करते हैं, जब भी कभी हम इन चीजों को करते हैं, तो हमें इस बात का ध्यान रखना पड़ेगा कि हम what days और उनकी theme को जरूर करें. Now if you say it's a static GK question, I don't agree with that. इट इज अ स्टैटिक जीके क्वेश्चन बट कमिंग इन द करंट कॉन्टेक्स्ट, मार्च का डेटा आ रहा है तो ये बात बहुत क्लियर हो चुकी है. इफ यू आर प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर 2022 और तुम लोग अगर मान लो इफ यू आर स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम से July 1, 2021, सो जुलाई से लेके मई तक का जितना भी डेटा होगा, जितने भी थीम्स होंगे, वो तुम्हें करने होंगे. यू कैनॉट डिनाई दैट. बट वन मोर ऑब्जर्वेशन, लुक एट द डेज दैट दे आर आस्किंग. वॉटर डे, वेटलैंड डे, दे आर नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट टॉयलेट डे और हैप्पीनेस डे और म्यूजिक डे फॉर दैट मैटर. दे आर नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट वेरी ऑब्सोलीट एंड वेरी डिफिकल्ट काइंड ऑफ डेज. ये बिल्कुल डुएबल डेज है. वॉटर इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इनग्रेडियंट ऑफ इंटर इकोलॉजिकल बैलेंस. बात बनती नजर आती है. सो डेफिनेटली डुएबल है और इजी क्वेश्चन है. अगला डेटा, इट सेज क्वेश्चन नंबर 3, इट सेज ऑन द ओकेजन ऑफ वर्ल्ड वाटर डे प्राइम मिनिस्टर नरेंद्र मोदी लॉन्च्ड अ कैंपेन नेम्ड कैच द रेन कैंपेन. बहुत बढ़िया. सो दिस पॉइंट हाईलाइट्स, ये पॉइंट ये हाईलाइट करता है कि किसी पर्टिकुलर डे में अगर गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया किसी इनिशिएटिव को लॉन्च कर रही है, so I need to pay attention to that. If you look at the Chabahar Day wala data also, Chabahar Port wala data also, it was about Maritime India Summit. So there are two learnings that I am coming out of. One is that the summits that are happening at international level, at the national level, and particularly on a particular day or date, that becomes very, very important. So that is what I need to build. चाहिए प्रेस इंफॉर्मेशन ब्यूरो में उसके बारे में जो छपा हुआ है, फ्रॉम देयर आई नीड टू ड्रॉ सम कंक्लूजंस मीनिंगफुली. सो एंड द ब्यूटी ऑफ अवर मंथन इज, जो मंथन हमारा पब्लिश होता है उसमें वन ऑफ द सोर्सेस प्रेस इंफॉर्मेशन ब्यूरो भी होती है, ऑल इंडिया रेडियो भी होता है. सो वी डू टेक केयर इनटू अकाउंट फ्रॉम वेयर एग्जैक्टली द पैसेजेस हैव बीन आस्क्ड. बाय द वे द आंसर वाज कैच द रेन. नाउ लुक एट दिस वन, इट्स एन इंटरेस्टिंग क्वेश्चन. इट सेज the national water mission has been considered under the national action plan for climate change launched by prime minister in 2009. Which of the following is not a goal? Dhyan rahe, whenever they ask the question which of the following is not true, not a goal, so usme tumhe, it's not necessary that you know all the data. Mostly you don't know, but if you read the passage ka options very, very closely, you will find there is an answer to that. Let me prove it with this question. Look at question option A. Comprehensive water database in public domain and assessment of the impact of climate change on water resource. Makes sense. Water resource par climate change ka kya impact hoga? Makes sense. Banta hai. Promotion of citizen and state actions for water conservation, augmentation and preservation. As the first of the question above that, it proves that catch the rain concept. Water conservation par focus ki baat ki ja rahi hai. Look at option number C. Comprehensive water database in public domain assessment of the impact of water resource on climate change. Can you clearly figure out what they have done is they have just changed option A. They've just changed the words climate change on water resource hona chahiye ya water resource on climate change. Logically water resource ka climate change pe impact utna direct nazar nahi aata hai. Climate change ka impact water resource pe direct nazar aata hai. So is this a difficult nut to crack? Many of the students feel bewildered looking at this question. Oh my God, so many options. I really don't understand the concept. Let me tell you, you don't really require to have a concept here. If you apply some common sense, you can crack this question. The answer is option C. If you look at even option D, increasing water efficiency button, that's okay. Anyone has to be true. This question is not talking about ABCD mein 1 and 2 is true or 2 or 3 is true. It's talking about which of the following is not true. Only one is not true. So you have boiled down to the conclusion of option C. That is the answer. Guys, many a times you look at the big written question and they say which of the following is not true or true and you get lost. My God, I need to have an ultra concept development. Then only I can... No, it's not the case most of the time. This question is a testimony to the fact. The answer is option C. We move on to question number 55. 2019, Ministry of Jal Shakti was formed after merging the Ministry of Drinking Water and Sanitation by and the Ministry of Ports, Shipping and Waterways. Logically rule out hota hai. Ports ke saath to iska merger nahi ho sakta hai. Water Conservation and Ganga Rejuvenation. Yes, this is slightly possible. Inland Waterways and Ganga Rejuvenation. Inland Waterways, it has to do with the river linking thing and all. Water Conservation, it's competent. Option A, Water Resources, River Development and Ganga Rejuvenation. If you apply little bit of common sense here, guys, if you see ports, shipping and waterways are water resources. If you apply water conservation and Ganga rejuvenation or inland waterways and Ganga rejuvenation also, both of them are developed with what? One is Ganga rejuvenation for sure, but water conservation and ports and all, they are linked with the development of the rivers also. So I can clearly see option A is the most logical conclusion of all the D, A, B, C, and D options. So to me, option A should be the right answer, and that is the right answer. So don't worry. See, I'm just sharing all these inputs to you so that you become ultra clear about all these things and not at all worried about it. So guys, we move on and just re-look at this question again. It's talking about a water day, celebration. Water day celebration ke upar ek passage aaya hai. So kya ye important hona chahiye? Hona chahiye. Because water is linked with, ecology and climate change and all. Sure, it's important. Coming from Press Information Bureau. So मुझे ध्यान रखना पड़ेगा जब इंडिया किसी भी पर्टिकुलर डे पर कोई सेलिब्रेशन कर रहा है एज ए कंट्री, प्रेस इंफॉर्मेशन ब्यूरो में उसके ऊपर छप रहा है, वी नीड टू पे अटेंशन टू दैट। क्वेश्चन नंबर 51, वेरी इजी क्वेश्चन, इजीली डूएबल क्वेश्चन। क्वेश्चन नंबर 52 डूएबल, फैक्चुअल। क्वेश्चन नंबर 53 इज अगेन अ फैक्चुअल क्वेश्चन, अगर जिसने थोड़ा बहुत भी ढंग से पढ़ा इसको कवर कर सकता है। क्वेश्चन नंबर 4 इज अ लॉजिकल क्वेश्चन, यू कैन क्रैक इट। क्वेश्चन नंबर 5 इज अगेन अ लॉजिकल क्वेश्चन लिटिल बिट, दो यू मे फाइंड इट स्लाइटली डिफिकल्ट। So I would say out of 5, you can crack at least 4. अगर तुमने अच्छे से चीजों को पढ़ा हुआ है तो, ठीक है? So this is my take on that. It's a current affairs topic. March का data है जो publish हुआ है. We move on to the second last topic here. And that is, there is really nothing new, not already anticipated in the distant past since the emergence of human species life nearly 2 million years ago. So a long prehistory of interfaith dialogue entailing a reciprocal relation between religious traditions and the outrobustness of very idea of being human and having rights precedes the recent UN movement of faith for rights, F4R. Makes sense. समझ में आता है. UN का एक topic है, इसको pick किया गया है. This question is coming from Indian Express. From right to faith to peace for all. Can we see the date of publication here? March 17, 2021. Current affairs का topic है. And it is coming from which source? It's basically a opinion column based article जो उपेंद्र बख्शी जो दिल्ली यूनिवर्सिटी के वाइस चांसलर रह चुके हैं उन्होंने लिखा है। There is really nothing new, not already in the distress planet and all this F4R and all this concept. From here to here, it's all in the passage. So rather than getting into the intricacies of the passage, can we please move on? To look at the actual passage kya tha, let's have a look at it and look at the questions underneath. Pehla data, when was the first human rights declaration adopted by the UNESCO? It's a purely static GK question, I completely agree, but in the context of the current affairs topic, we all know very well that Human Rights Day is celebrated on 10th of December. Can you apply a little bit of common sense here? December 10 option hona chahiye, either A or C. Now UN ki jo establishment hai वो 24th October 1945 की है। So can you really understand कि इतनी जल्दी वो human rights का declaration launch कर सकते? So logically it sounds to me as option C. I'll go with that. So मैं, please don't misunderstand me. मुझे गलत मत समझो. See, I am not at all promoting तुक्केबाजी और logical conclusions. No. But when I'm saying logically speaking, it seems a possibility. So it's up to your gut feeling and your reading, awareness that you have done so far. You should go ahead and try this one out. In fact, this is the answer. Let me tell you that. The answer to this particular question is option C. That is the correct answer. Now let's look at another question. Agla question dekhte hain. The United Nations Human Rights Council is a non-governmental body. Can it be a non-governmental body when UN is there? No. Can it be a quasi-governmental body? I mean, is it bounded by law? Quasi money, half, semi, so not really. Is it a multi-stakeholder? Yes, it is a multi-stakeholder. Bahut sare log isme involved hai, that's for sure. Is it an intergovernmental? Definitely, it's an intergovernmental body. Common sense apply kar do. Governments isme involved hongi. Within the government, isko fulfill karne ki baat ki jati hai. So this is the most... the option A and option D looks to me slightly familiar, but I believe that option A is much, much clearer as compared to rest of the options. So, yahan bhi aapko apni knowledge aur thodi si common sense ki understanding ko project karke use karna padega. The answer is option A for sure. we move on to the next one. And the next one is the Universal Declaration of Human Rights and the International Convention on Economic Justice and the International Justice. Now, this is a difficult question. Ye bahut difficult sawal hai. The answer to this question, I completely agree, is not doable, though the answer is International Bill of Human Rights. So, isme aap elimination apply nahin kar sakte. It's a difficult one. I completely accept that. So, aisa agar question nahin bhi kar paoge, mereko chalega. Koi tension nahi hai mereko. Ek chiz aur, start accepting the fact ki GK is really very, very vast. And don't start thinking, ki agar GK mein 35 question aaye, to main 35 hi karke chhodunga. Your goal should be 35. That is true. But please don't die for that. ये नहीं कि 35 नहीं आ रहे हैं तो आई एम फीलिंग डिजेक्टेड लॉस्ट एंड नॉट डन. आई एम एब्सोल्युटली ओके विद 25 प्लस का स्कोर. मार्क माय वर्ड्स वंस अगेन, इफ यू आर अचीविंग 25 प्लस आउट ऑफ 35, एनीथिंग बिटवीन 25 टू 30 इज अ वेरी गुड स्कोर इन जीके, लुकिंग एट द वास्ट एरिया दैट इट कवर्स, लुकिंग एट द एवर ग्रोइंग डेवलपमेंट्स दैट आर हैपनिंग इन करंट जीके. वी मूव ऑन टू अनदर वन क्वेश्चन. एंड द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ फेथ फॉर राइट्स इज प्रोवाइड. नाउ इफ यू सी right to is to provide space for cross disciplinary reflection and action on the deep and mutually enriching connections between religious and human rights. Now here it says mutually enriching connections between religious and human rights. If you read the options, it says the following is not true. So you need to be alert. Whenever they say not true, you need to be alert. Isme kya common sense lag sakta hai kya agar mujhe nahi pata to? Can I look at option number 4 to promote religious dogmatism? Is it not absolutely contrary to what is written in the question? At one place, they are talking about, you know, mutual energy connections between religious and human rights. And here they are talking about religious dogmatism. So which of the following is not true? Obviously, option D is the correct answer. So I am going to highlight a very important point here. The students are really lost by looking at such questions when they say, which of the following is not true? And they start concluding that when they say, which of the following is not true, I need to be very much clear conceptually. And that is why they start going deeper into the concepts. No, I am very clear. Main is baat ko bahut clearly bol dena chahta hun. Take my word, guys and girls. You are preparing for a 12th class pass examination. Though the nature is God, but they are not. I'm too clear about it. You can see it. It's there in front of you. Look at the questions. You can apply common sense. You can apply some common existing knowledge and above average amount of knowledge if you possess. So that is good, more than enough to crack such questions. By the way, the answer to this question is option D. And with this, we move on to another question. That is question number 60. It says, in India, which of the following statutory organizations is responsible for the protection of the human rights? See, if you are preparing for law, you should know human rights is the basis of law. If you talk about India, to India mein to NHRC hai. And this question is asked because NHRC mein bhi recently Arun Mishra ji ka change hua tha. Agar aapko pata ho. Supreme Court ke judge rahe hai wo. Pehle, agar tumhe malum ho, हाई कोर्ट के जो चीफ जस्टिस हैं उनको भी अब एनएचआरसी का चेयरपर्सन, ये अमेंडमेंट हुआ था एनएचआरसी के अंदर. एनएचआरसी का, अगर तुम्हें ह्यूमन राइट्स की बात कर रहे हो, तुम्हें अगर एमनेस्टी इंटरनेशनल का नहीं पता और ह्यूमन राइट्स की बॉडी एनएचआरसी का नहीं पता, तो ये प्रिपरेशन में कमी है डेफिनेटली ना. एनएचआरसी 1993 में एस्टेब्लिश हुआ था, इफ आई एम नॉट रॉन्ग. आई हैव टू क्रॉस चेक. द फर्स्ट वन इज प्रोबेबली पीएन भगवती और रंगनाथ मिश्रा, एनी वन ऑफ देम. उनमें से कोई ना कोई एक बंदा उसका चेयरपर्सन बना था. आज तक सिर्फ एक्स सीजीआई ही चेयरपर्सन बने थे और दिस टाइम मिस्टर अरुण मिश्रा हैज बीन अपॉइंटेड. ही वाज प्रोबेबली अ जज इन द सुप्रीम कोर्ट इफ आई एम नॉट रॉन्ग. सो इट वाज वेरी मच इन द न्यूज. इट टॉक्स अबाउट स्टैट्यूटरी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. टेस्ट योर अंडरस्टैंडिंग. स्टैट्यूटरी मींस बाय लॉ, मतलब इट इज एस्टैब्लिश्ड बाय लॉ. इट्स नॉट कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल. ओरिजिनली कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन में नहीं था. 1993 में एनएचआरसी एक्ट के थ्रू बना है. सो इंडिया की जो फोरमोस्ट बॉडी है एनएचआरसी. इट्स फेयरली इजी नट टू क्रैक. The look at the beauty. It says National Human Rights Council, Human Rights Commission, Human Rights Organization, Human Rights Council. So, in fact, usme human rights mein Indian dal diya. Can you see how they are creating the options? National Human Rights Commission ka naam baar baar aata hai. Jo bhi thoda bahut well read hai, isko easily crack kar sakta hai. And the answer to this particular question is surely National Human Rights Commission, option B. So, let me go through this passage once more. Ek baar fir se isko dekhna chahunga. This is a data, you know, which is coming from an article. मैंने उसकी डेट भी आपको दिखाई थी, जैसा कि मैंने तुम्हें समझाया. इसमें जो questions थे, एक question common sense logic से होता है, factual है. दूसरा common sense का question, इसमें concept की जरूरत नहीं है. तीसरा difficult है, मुश्किल है. चौथा pure common sense से religious dogmatism. और पांचवा सवाल जनरल अवेयरनेस के ऊपर है, एनएचआरसी। सो दिस नॉट अ स्ट्रैटेजी के क्वेश्चन गाइस, ये तो करंट अफेयर्स में न्यूज में आता रहता है, अरुण मिश्रा जी का नाम आया हुआ है बार बार न्यूज के अंदर, और डेटा ये मार्च का डेटा छपा हुआ है। तो अगर हम इनको बार बार लेबल करेंगे स्ट्रैटेजी के, आई एम रियली सॉरी, आई डोंट बाय दिस आर्ग्यूमेंट, स्ट्रैटेजी के है मगर इन द कंटेक्स्ट ऑफ करंट अफेयर्स है। सो जो बच्चा करंट अफेयर्स ढंग से कर रहा है और उसको ढंग से प्रिपेयर कर रहा है, मैं नहीं समझता इसको तुम स्टैटिक का लेबल लगा के डिफिकल्ट कर सकते। Now in the last leg of this recording, let me move on. Coronavirus hit the world. India emphasized the imperative collaboration on the medical health. SARC fund generated kiya India ne. So India, this passage is basically talking about India's role in COVID management across the globe, along with the country. Let's look at the questions. Minister of Health and Family Welfare. Now this is a very interesting observation. This is the development of the probably first week of July. मनसुख मांडविया वॉज इन द न्यूज, हर्षवर्धन जी हटा दिए गए थे, प्रकाश जावड़ेकर हट गए थे, तुम्हें पता ही होगा रमेश पोखरियाल निशंक ने हेल्थ के चलते अपने रीजन से रिजाइन किया था। तो तुम्हें समझना पड़ेगा कि ये जो क्वेश्चन है ये जुलाई के फर्स्ट वीक का डेटा है। नाउ आई वॉन्ट टू जस्टिफाई कि जब हम तुम लोगों को पढ़ाते हैं तो हम तुम्हें ये कहते हैं कि 7 days prior to the actual examination, I think this is a proof enough कि मनसुख मांडविया चेयरपर्सन बन गए हैं। सो दिस क्वेश्चन इज लॉस्ट, इट्स अ ऑब्जेक्टिव क्वेश्चन, इजीली डूएबल। Next one is SARC fund कब बना था? By the way, इसकी source भी देखना चाहूंगा मैं। Give me a second, please. This question is coming from an article written by a famous, political thinker. His name is Ashok Sajjanhar, Vaccine Maitri Initiative. And look at the date of publication, January 29, 2021. So this news item is from the month of January. It's a hardcore current affairs data. Read it out. Here's the data. As soon as the coronavirus hit the world, impetu collaborator on the SARC fund to combat 10 million. So they have created the question from the passage itself. 10 million hata diya, question generate kar diya. That is how they have created the questions. Guys, I hope you are seeing the sources and things are becoming ultra clear to all of you now. The first data, Mansukh Mandaviya, kya fund banaya tha? 10 million ka fund tha. Objective question hai. First to receive supplies of vaccine from India, Bhutan and Maldives. This is slightly difficult, but जिन्होंने अच्छे से पढ़ाई की होगी वो क्रैक कर सकते हैं। ऑब्जेक्टिव क्वेश्चन, क्या नाम था इनिशिएटिव का? वैक्सीन मैत्री। ये तो कॉमन सेंस से कर सकते हो, वैक्सीन मैत्री हो सकता है, डुएबल है। एंड द लास्ट वन, कोवैक्सीन को किसने डेवलप किया? ICMR एंड भारत बायोटेक। अगर किसी एक बच्चे को भारत बायोटेक भी पता हो तो कोई ऑप्शन और ऑप्शन भारत बायोटेक है ही नहीं, मतलब एक ही ऑप्शन है। और ये भी समझना पड़ेगा कि एक्चुअली इसका जो कॉम्बिनेशन, ये ऑप्शन इसमें और अच्छी हो सकती थी, ये इंडियन काउंसिल ऑफ मेडिकल रिसर्च प्लस नेशनल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ वायरोलॉजी और भारत बायोटेक ने इसको डेवलप किया। तो अगर आप थोड़ी बहुत भी नॉलेज रखें तो इसको क्रैक कर सकते हैं, बहुत ही इजी क्वेश्चन है। कोवैक्सीन इज द वैक्सीन जो इंडिजिनसली प्रोड्यूस्ड इन इंडिया है। सो इफ यू लुक एट ऑल दिस क्वेश्चंस, दिस इज अ पैसेज ऑन कोविड कोवैक्सीन, आई मीन वैक्सीन के ऊपर पैसेज है, जनवरी का डेटा है, कमिंग फ्रॉम अ IDSA वेबसाइट। Questions are, all of them are doable. Pure current affairs factual questions. Only one is troublesome. Okay. So, we move on again. And the next, जो पीछे वाला F4R, ये जो data आया है, ये Indian Express के through आया है. March का data है, if you see. और इसमें भी questions जो है, common sense apply करके doable है. ऐसा नहीं है कि बहुत difficult questions है. Then we look at UNESCO का data, March का data है. Press Information Bureau का data है, ये doable questions थे. जो गलवान वैली कॉन्फ्लिक्ट का डेटा है, इसकी सोर्स पे जाते हैं, फटाफट इसकी सोर्स को कवर करते हैं। दिस पैसेज इज कमिंग फ्रॉम हिंदू, ओके, हिंदू न्यूज़पेपर का पैसेज है, एक्सप्लेन्ड टॉपिक के अंदर। लुक एट द, लेट मी जस्ट शेयर द पैसेज, मैं एक बार शेयर कर देता हूं आपको, सो दैट यू आर एबल टू रियली सी दैट। और इसको लेके बहुत हंगामा है बच्चों में कि सर पास्ट के टॉपिक्स उठ करके आ गए। लेट्स लुक एट दैट, कितने पास्ट का टॉपिक है। लुक एट द क्वेश्चन, लुक एट द डेट हियर, कैन यू सी? The date of publication is February 15, 2021. The disengagement plan between India and China along the LAC. ये 2021 की February का data है, hardcore current affair data है, ठीक है? Can we look at the actual passage here? Starting in April 2020, China amidst the large number of, let me show it again to you. मैं दोबारा दिखा देता हूँ आपको, ताकि आपको doubt ना रहे, ये वहीं से उठ के आया है। Look at this. Starting in April, China amidst the large number of troops and all, this was there. So this is the passage. Now, Let us look at the questions. Questions को देखते हैं बहुत जल्दी से। Violent clashes happened on which date? Now this question, honestly speaking, too much to ask for because they are talking about a date on which it happened. If you have a broad idea, if you are reading it thoroughly, then only you can crack it. Though the answer to this particular question is, let me tell you, the answer to this question is option C, 15-16 June ko ye ghatna ghati. Now the next one, agla question dekhte hain. कहां पर हुई थी गलवान वैली. आई थिंक इट्स अ डूएबल डेटा, बिल्कुल कर सकते हैं. ये तो बहुत ही इजी डेटा है, इसमें कुछ भी नहीं है. वी मूव ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट वन. वायलेंट इंसिडेंट लीडिंग टू डेथ ऑफ सोल्जर्स हैपेंड. नाउ दिस इज अ वेरी 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 स्पेसिफिक डिटेल. ये बहुत ही स्पेसिफिक डिटेल है. एंड इट टॉक्स अबाउट कौन से पेट्रोल पॉइंट पे हुआ था. ये बहुत ज्यादा है. पेट्रोल 14 इज द आंसर. लाइन ऑफ एक्चुअल कंट्रोल, यस ये डूएबल है. अगर आप ढंग से पढ़ाई कर रहे हो 3-4 किलोमीटर बनता है, ये हो सकता है, बिल्कुल डिफिकल्ट नहीं है ये. And the last one, just a moment, the last data is which of the following was resolved by way of an agreement between India and China. If you read all, it says Chinese had moved back, both sides will demolish structures, moratorium, petroleum, all of them. So, ye common sense se hota nazar aata. Isme mujhe jo problematic question lag raha hai, wo 46 lag raha hai aur question number 48 lag raha hai. Baki sab doable hai. If you look at all of them, they are purely factual data. None of them is a conceptual one. Except of option number 50, question number 50. One conceptual question. So guys and girls, this is the analysis of the CLAT 2021 paper. Now, I would like to, you know, highlight a few things once more. Main dobara se kuch baatein highlight karna chahta hoon. The purpose of this analysis was to give you a clear-cut picture as to what exactly came in the CLAT paper. I hope it was a meaningful one to you. Few observations. Kindly take them as takeaways. Number one, the myth that is there ki static GK se bahut sare sawal aaye hain. You have clearly seen ki bahut sare nahi aaye hain, gine chune questions aaye hain. Maine har ek passage mein highlight kiya hai aur wo bhi wo questions hain jo us context mein aaye hain. Iska dhyan rakhna hai. Mere hisab se static GK ka perception ye hota hai ki tum achanak se history ka sawal puch lo, economics ka sawal puch lo, biology ka sawal puch lo aur ज्योग्राफी का क्वेश्चन पूछ लो. सो क्वेश्चन पूछे गए हैं डिफरेंट जगहों से. दे आर इन द कंटेक्स्ट ऑफ द करंट अफेयर्स. सो मार्क माय वर्ड्स, व्हेन यू डू करंट अफेयर्स थॉरली, यू कवर ऑल दीज थिंग्स ऑलरेडी. सो इसमें अलग से तुम्हें स्टैटिक जीके पढ़ने की बिल्कुल भी जरूरत नहीं. टेक इट फ्रॉम दिस इज नंबर वन. नंबर टू, द पैसेजेस हैव बीन पिक्ड ड्यूरिंग द टाइम पीरियड ऑफ डिसंबर टू मार्च. एक जनवरी का आर्टिकल था, दो फरवरी के थे, एक मार्च का था, एक दिसंबर का था, और एक डेटा जुलाई का भी था, मनसुख मंडाविया का. तो अगर आपसे ये कहा जाए कि लास्ट जो टाइम पीरियड है लास्ट एग्जाम के बीच में और आगे के एग्जाम के बीच में, ये उसी के बीच में से लाई कर रहा है, कहीं से बाहर से नहीं आया है. इवन इफ यू टॉक अबाउट द गलवान वैली कॉन्फ्लिक्ट, भले ही वो जून 2020 का डेटा है, बट उसकी डेवलपमेंट इवेंचुअली जो हुई है वो 2021 में हुई है फरवरी के अंदर. So if you're covering the current affairs thoroughly, you cannot call it as an old data or मुझे 16 महीने का डेटा कवर करना है, 14 महीने का डेटा कवर करना है. No, big no. You need to do only between what was the last paper, what is the ensuing paper. उसके बीच के डेटा को कवर करना है. I hope it is making lot of clarity to you. Number three, students are very much worried about the depth of the study. You have seen the questions very clearly. सबने questions देख लिए. क्या सारे क्वेश्चंस कॉन्सेप्चुअल थे? देयर वर हार्डली 3-4 क्वेश्चंस विच वर कॉन्सेप्चुअल, 3-4, नॉट मोर देन दैट. एंड रेस्ट ऑफ देम विच अपीयर्ड टू बी कॉन्सेप्चुअल, दे वर नॉट एक्चुअली कॉन्सेप्चुअल, दे वर बेस्ड ऑन कॉमन सेंस एंड रीडिंग्स. लुक एट द रिलीजियस डॉगमेटिज्म वाला क्वेश्चन ऑफ एफ4 आर राइट्स वाला, रिमेंबर. Look at that, वो इफेक्ट ऑफ क्लाइमेट चेंज ऑन वाटर रिसोर्स, ओनली द ऑप्शंस आर चेंज्ड. सो एक बहुत बड़ी मिथ है जो बच्चों में एंटर कर रही है कि मुझे डिटेल में पढ़ना है. सी आई एम नॉट एंटी टू डिटेल स्टडी, बट आई एम वेरी क्लियर, डिटेल का मतलब, डेप्थ का मतलब डेफिनेटली ये नहीं है कि आप जो है वो बहुत ही सुपर रिसर्च करेंगे. नो, एक नॉर्मल लॉ एस्पिरेंट से क्या एक्सपेक्टेड है, जो 12th पास करके आया है उससे क्या एक्सपेक्टेड है. यू नीड टू प्रिपेयर इट to a mediocre level of understanding. Don't go too deep, not required, guys. I'm really sorry, but I want to highlight this again because you put your lot of energies into that, you waste your lot of time into that. I believe agar tum common sense se padhai kar rahe ho, it's not a big deal to do. Common sense se moderate level tak clarity lekar ke chalo, ye easily doable questions. So another observation, are these questions too much of factual in nature? Absolutely yes. You can see the paper for yourself. Around 90% plus questions have been asked from the factual data. So the paper is majorly factual in nature. And one more observation. When you say that I need to read this newspaper, that newspaper, this thing, that thing, can you see if you are reading those newspapers in this expectation that the passage will come from this newspaper only? I'm sorry, it's incorrect. It's irrelevant. If you see, I'm not saying don't read Hindu, don't read Indian Express. No, I'm not saying that. Read only what goodness newspaper. That will do. No need to study 2, 3, 4 newspapers. I hope I'm making it ultra clear to all of you. Read one good national daily. That will do. Be it Hindu or be it Indian Express. I'm okay with any one of them. They're very good. One more word of advice. If you see the sources, many of them came from Press Information Bureau. Many of them came. One came from Indian Express. One came from Hindu. One came from Free Press Journal. One came from IDSA. And 2 to 3 came from PIB. So can I pay more attention to, if you see in totality, you'll find that most of the passages have been focused on India's initiatives, India's goals, India's issues. So the whole focus is on either India or common issues of the world. So this is something which has come. Though I would admit that the questions that have been asked, the passages that have been asked, we are nobody to question why they have been asked and why Israel Palestine is not there, Afghanistan is not there. See, these were my expectations. They did not turn up. Can't help it. But please understand that you are at the receiver's end. So whatever examiner is asking, you need to prepare for that. So don't be too cling. Don't cling to too much of expectations. Ki maine jo padha hai wohi aayega. No, I'm too clear. I need to be neutral. Meri preparation solid honi chahiye, clarity honi chahiye. Come what may, I will handle that. Okay. And one very, very interesting observation here. Students generally interpret that Manthan 2.0 is more important than weekly Manthan. I am really sorry to say this. Both of them are equally important. In one particular dimension, I would say weekly Manthan is very important as compared to Manthan 2.0 when it comes to coverage of the issues involved, especially for CLAT paper and for non-CLAT paper. Though weekly Manthan is the best. Usse aada kuch bhi nahi karne ki zarurat hai. Probably I'll come up with a video of NLU Delhi GK analysis also. That will bring a lot of clarity to you. And in this session, I have tried my level best to explain things to you and give you some clarity about how the GK 2021 was there in the paper. What is my thoughts on this? I have shared whatever I could feel I should share and wanted to bring more clarity to you. So my suggestion to you would be, have a very, very common and balanced approach. Do read widely, of course, become clear. And then the most important mantra of CLAT GK is follow the principle, which talks about what of the issue, why of the issue, and how of the issue. First, you need to identify which is an important issue. Just identify the important issue. Two, know what is that issue all about. Understand that wo issue hai kya. Three, why is that issue? Kyon hua hai wo issue? India-China conflict hua to kyon hua? Samajh mein aa raha hai? And how? Jab main how ki baat karta hun, to please understand, jab main what ki baat karta hun, uske present facts wagera cover ho jate. Issue samajh mein aata hai. Jab main why ki baat karta hun, to uski history touch ho jati hai. Hai na? Uski history touch ho jayegi, kyon hua, pehle kya hua tha, wahan se baat chalti aa rahi hai, yahan problem aa rahi hai. Aur jab main how ki baat karta hun, to how takes care of the present scenario, uspe latest developments kya hai. Look at the question of look at the question of COVID vaccine ka jo passage aaya tha. Look at the question of Mansukh Mandavia, the health minister of India. Look at the question of Covaxin developed by Bharat Biotech. The best part in this paper was that they have tested your current knowledge in the light of the ongoing important issues. So those of you who are thinking of mugging up the data, not applying common sense, and not understanding the issues in contention, I think this paper is not for you. You need to just focus on important issues. At the same time, try to finish them from 3 perspectives. What, why, and how. In perspectives, inko padhna shuru karo. Attend the regular classes, attend the sessions of master strokes that we keep on conducting. I am very, very sure that if you understand this message that I am trying to share with you thoroughly, CLAT GK will not be a problem. And one more last word, I cannot refrain from saying this. Don't overdo GK, please, for God's sake. There are so many students who keep on doing GK, overdo kar dete hain, confuse ho jate hain, data retain nahi kar pate. Whatever you do, do with clarity, with conceptual clarity, revise that, try to add knowledge to whatever you can add to. And that is how you need to prepare the CLAT GK for the year 2022. With this, I would like to thank you all for this, wonderful opportunity to interact with you. Want to say a big thank you. Wish you all the very best in your journey of CLAT 2022. Happy GKing. Thank you very much. Take care. Bye-bye for now.